In this video, I'm going to give you a very quick introduction to how our transformer models work together with TensorFlow and Keras. The very short explanation is that all of our TensorFlow models are also Keras model objects, and so they have the standard Keras model API. If you're an experienced machine learning engineer who's used Keras a lot, that's probably all you need to know to start working with them. But for everyone else, including the prodigal PyTorch engineers out there who are returning to the fold, I'm going to quickly introduce Keras models and how we work with them. In other videos, which I'll link below, I'll run through training with Keras models in more detail. But first, at a high level, what is a Keras model? So your model basically contains your entire network. It contains the layers and the weights for those layers, and also tells the model what to do with them. So it defines the whole path all the way from your inputs to your outputs. If you've used Keras before, you probably started using model objects by building them out by hand. You added one layer after another, maybe using the model.add or the functional approach. And there's nothing wrong with that. Lots of great models are built that way, but you can also preload an entire model, weights and all. And this is really helpful because as you can see here, if you try reading the paper or if you try looking at the code, you'll see the inside of a transformer is pretty complex, and writing it all out from scratch and getting it right would be hard even for an experienced machine learning engineer. But because it's all packed inside a model, you don't need to worry about that complexity on that if you don't want to. If you're a researcher, if you want to really dig in there, you can. But you can also just load a pre-trained, pre-configured transformer model in just one line of code. And when I mentioned earlier about the Keras API, the advantage of it is that whether you write your own model from scratch or load a pre-trained one, you interact with the model through that same API. So you use exactly the same few methods, and you're going to see them again and again. These methods like fit, compile, and predict. And like I mentioned, we'll see cover concrete examples of how to use those methods in the videos I'll link below. For now, the key thing to take away from this video, if you've never seen Keras before, is that this neat encapsulation means that all the complexity of a huge neural net becomes manageable because you interact with it in exactly the same way, using exactly the same methods, whether it's a huge pre-trained language model or a simple model you wrote out by hand.